And I appreciate your guys' attention on that sort of administrative, the house cleaning, housekeeping detail stuff. Regarding the orientation, you got it. Oregon Raceway Park is 2.3 miles long, 40 feet wide all the way around. It has over 400 feet of elevation change. So be ready, yes. Be ready for a lot of hills, a lot of off-camber, and a lot of blind corners. I'll go ahead and walk through the track with you guys, but I'm pretty sure that once you bolt on your helmet, you get in the seat, most of this will get forgotten. So we're gonna do a pace lap, and then we'll turn you guys loose on some outlaps. Turn two is blind, and it's a right-hander, so be aware of that. This is all downhill going into turn three, so be aware of your brakes as you're coming down this hill. There'll be chicanes up as well. Turn three is off camber, turn four is off camber. Turn five is a slight rise. This is all uphill up to turn six. Be mindful of turn six. It's downhill and fast. You guys will see lots of places where people have left the racing surface because it is, you don't want to apex early. This is our signature section. It's the half pipe. 14 degrees of banking in the half pipe. Turn eight is uphill and blind. This is all uphill till about there, where it goes at the kink. There's a downhill section going into a heavy braking zone. So mind your brakes here as well. Brakes here. That's a slowest corner on the course. Down the hill into turn 10. Turn 10 is uphill, blind. So this is all uphill. And I don't care what you're in. And turn 11 is flat to the floor. I mean, it's a fast corner. You can be in a, I don't know, a 500 horsepower Viper, you're gonna be going up the hill flat out. But turn 12 is really where you guys need to be careful. We're in a wheat field. There's nothing to hit out here, except if you hook a wheel and spin into the wall on the front straight, which protects us from being collected by anybody who spins there. So you'll see some red paint on out on that wall. That red paint is a Ferrari. So the deal is that if you get into trouble, drive straight. It's easier to clean off the cars. We have water. We don't have this pretty new color of Volvo paint. Volvo Corporation chose Oregon Raceway Park because of all of the terrain features out here, the natural beauty. You have a beautiful product. You've got a beautiful place to go check into it. What we're gonna do is we are gonna go out for a pace lap. That's all of us. So I will be in the red XC60. Everybody is gonna get into the cars. There'll be a driver and a passenger, okay? But that's just for one pace lap. We'll go relatively slow for the orientation lap and come back in the pits. Then the passenger gets out. No hot laps with passengers. The passenger gets out. Then you will be the drivers will be released on a 10-second interval. You will get two laps, an out lap, and then when you come up the hill, you will get a checkered flag and a pit in board. Come into the pits. Driver gets out, passenger do-si-dos into the former passenger, then gets in and does their lap. Any questions? Sorry. Go do your out lap, and then when you come back on that second lap, you will get a checkered flag and a pit in board.
So we do pass the pits once.
You will pass the pits once. Correct. Good question. Other questions?
No passing, period.
No passing. Thank you. There is no passing. We're going to be using three flags. I think everybody knows what that flag is for. I hope. What does this flag mean? Yeah.
Your fun is over.
Your fun is over. If you see this flag, They will be at all stations and you need to come home. We won't use this flag, right?
Someone else's fun is over prematurely.
And that means everybody's fun is over. There's one other flag.
There's me flag.
This is a debris flag. If somebody goes off course, you will drive straight, right? Because if you drive straight, your plan, chances are you'll just get the car dusty. But when you come back on course, you might bring something with you, but nobody's going off course. So we won't use this flag either. But this is a debris flag. Okay? Questions? All right, guys, grab your helmets and follow me.
Wait, guys, hang on one sec. Just a quick reminder about these cars. So you have the 4C active chassis on these cars. So you can adjust the chassis, but also there is a sport mode for the traction control system. All of these cars have that traction control, the anti-spin system turned off. There's still a measure of stability control, but it just allows for greater rear wheel slip angle. So just so you know, if you want it on, you just cycle the car on and off and